one and all. My name is Rhea. Welcome back to another Matchday video. So, once again, for the second week in a row, today's video is going to be a bit different. So, I am going on another ground up because, as you may know, last weekend, Chester SC should have been away at Darlington, but it got called off due to a waterlogged pitch at the last minute. So, we decided to go and watch Shrewsbury Town versus Wycombe Wanderers Skybet League One. It was a decent game, to be honest. And this weekend, Chester SC should have been at home against Stockport County. But Stockport down in the FA Trophy semi-final second leg against Hayley Fowl today. So the first leg was last weekend at Mill Farm and Stockport drew the other way. So I'm going to go to Spotland, otherwise known as the Crown Oil Arena due to sponsorship reasons. So I'm going to watch Rochdale versus Scunthorpe United in Skybet League One. So it should be a good game today. And last weekend I did make a comment on a massive relegation battle in League 1 because only 3 points separate 12th place Plymouth Argyle from 21st place Walsall, who operate the final relegation spot. So it's one hell of a relegation dogfight there. So you know, and also both Rochdale and Scunthorpe are in that, you know, are in that dogfight as well. So both sides will be hoping to get the 3 points today, otherwise, you know, where the team who does lose today will be in a bit of a you know, they will be in massive trouble today. So it should be good game today. So first of all, let's start off with Rochdale, because last season they survived relegation on the last day of the season, because I remember them beating Charlton Athletic at home on the last day of the season. And so far this season, they had a bit of a decent start. However, since then they have struggled a little bit, and Keyfield, the club legend at Rochdale, he got sacked a couple of weeks ago. However, caretaker manager Brian Barry Murphy, he came in, and so far he's done quite well, to be honest. So he has been there for two games. Now it's opening two games and he picked up 4 points. So first of all, Rochdale, they beat Shrewsbury Town at home, and then the following Tuesday they drew against Oxford United. So he has done quite well, to be honest. So he's made a decent start there, and Rochdale, they'll be hoping to stay up for the second season in a row, because they wouldn't want to drop down to League 2. So you know, it's a massive game for Rochdale and also for Scunthorpe, because Scunthorpe, as you may know, in the last season they got to the League 2 playoffs, and you know, they got to the semi-finals there. But so far the season they have been in a bit of free-fall, because they have struggled for most of the season as well. So they're just a couple of places above the relegation zone. So you know, under Stuart McCauley, he has a lot of experience at this level, because he was he used to be at Bradford City, and also he has a spot in Scotland with Motherwell as well. So he knows this league, and he knows English football really well, and also he has a bit of a spell in Scotland too. So Stuart McCauley is really experienced at this level, so he will know what it is like to be in the relegation battle. But for both sides, today it's a massive game for them both. So it is a bit of a 6-pointer as well. So can't wait for the game today. It should be a good one as well. So my score prediction is Rochdale 2, Scunthorpe United 1. So for Rochdale, I think Calvin will score for them, and also Ian Henderson. And for Scunthorpe, I think Kevin Van Veen will score for them. So I think it'll be a tight game, but in the end, Rochdale, they have home advantage as well, so I think they'll win today. However, I am going in the Scunthorpe pen today, so hopefully Scunthorpe will win. But to be honest, I don't really have any affinity with either side really, so I don't really care who wins, but it just gets me out of the house, I suppose. So Chester SC are back in action on Wednesday, so thank God for that, because they want to go on another ground. So yeah, can't wait for the game today. It should be a good one as well. So of course, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like, subscribe as usual, and also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. Match day highlights will be coming up right now, so stay tuned. Let's go into it. First we run and then we laugh till we cry.
Here is Rochdale's squad for today's game. And here is Scunthorpe United's squad for today's match. I hope you enjoyed the video.
Don't lose that header there. haven't seen Danny Willey today. Yeah.
Thompson, you've not won one yet.
Not won one, I hold that. Yeah,
I don't mind if you've got that in front of you. fucking useless. He's fucking useless.
Rochdale 3, Scunthorpe United 1. So I enjoyed that today. I thought it was a good game, and no, it wasn't anything, you know, compared to following Chester, but I thought it was a decent match today. 4-2, and also it had a bit of an, you know, had a bit of a significant effect on the League One relegation battle as well. So Rochdale got a deserving today, but you know, to be honest, I thought it was a bit of, you know, a game of two halves in my, you know, my opinion, because in the first half, well, Scunthorpe, they had, you know, they absolutely hammered Rochdale. You know, they should have been 4-1 up at half time, but you know, they just didn't convert any chances. So the first half, well, you know, Scunthorpe, they were by far the better team. They played some good football on, and it was a bit of a tricky surface today. The pitch wasn't in the best condition, but Scunthorpe, they were fantastic in the first half. However, in the second half, though. I'm going to talk to you, you know, more about it in a minute, because Rochdale, they were fantastic. But anyway, on to the first half, you know, I'll talk to you about that first. So, you know, as I said before, Scunthorpe, they were the better side. Yeah, they lost the chances, but it was actually Rochdale who, do, you know, did make it 1-0. You know, their player there made it 1-0, decent goal. Then just a couple of minutes later, Scunthorpe, their player made it 1-0. And a nice, you know, decent finish into the bottom left-hand corner. And it was a good goal to make it 1-0. And the atmosphere was really good today. You know, even when they were 3-1 down, Scunthorpe, you know, the fans were still singing today. So fair play to their fans. You know, they took about, I think it was 578 they took today. So, you know, considering Scunthorpe is a couple of hours away from Rochdale, then, you know, that's a fantastic, you know, fantastic following today. Yeah, yeah. So Scunthorpe, they made it 1-0, and after that they had a number of chances to make it 2-1. However, you know, the Rochdale defence, you know, they shut them out on a number of occasions, and you know, Scunthorpe, yeah, you know, just couldn't find the composure really. So 1-0 half time, you know, decent first half, and the second half was even better, to be honest, because Rochdale, they made it 2-1. You know, decent flick on you know, by their player, we made it 2-1. Then after that, you know, Rochdale, they continued to pile on the pressure. But must say, you know, a few of the Scunthorpe fans who were by me, they were, you know, having a right go their team today, you know, in the second half. And, you know, also especially it's Stuart McCall, their manager, you know, it's quite obvious that they're not happy with him there. So he did make a couple of wrong decisions, you know, especially in the second half. You know, we left a few of their substitutions a little bit late on in the game, where Rochdale were cruising at the time. But, you know, Scunthorpe, they were very poor in the second half. You know, they made a number of misplaced passes, and also they were just ducking away from Jules, headers, and in the second balls as well. They were just really poor in the second half as well. But Rochdale, must give them credit today, because in the second half they were really good. You know, compared to the first half, you know, where they were a bit, you know, a bit tired and a bit sloppy. But in the second half they were much better. You know, they had a lot of heart, fight, and, you know, desire, and, you know, they've shown a lot more aggression than they did in the first period. And you know, they just deserved to win today, I thought, because Scunthorpe, they were really poor, but Rochdale, they capitalised on that really well. So fair play, for thought, you know, they did really well today. And then the first Rochdale came, goal came, you know, I think it was on the 60th minute mark. So for Rochdale, they were really good today. Their, you know, their supporters were really good as well. So, you know, wish both sides all the best for the rest of the season. It will be interesting to see how the League One relegation battle does go on, because on the basis of that today, Scunthorpe, they could be, you know, they could be a bet to go down. But Rochdale, if they continue their fighting spirit up now, because, excuse me, they have picked 7 points up now, you know, in the first three games under their caretaker manager spell there. So they are picking up a lot, you know, massively there. So, you know, if they do stay up this season, they won't be surprised at all. So, you know, for Rochdale, they were fantastic in the second half, but Scunthorpe, they were awful, to be honest, and even their fans were saying as well. So a few of their supporters aren't happy, but you know, these were the out for me today. I did enjoy it. But anyway, Chester SC finally back in action on Wednesday night, where we make the long journey up to the North East to play Darlington away. So it's a massive game for us. We've got to get a win there, so I am hoping to go to that game. So if I do go, then I will load the match day preview on Tuesday night. Then of course on Wednesday we'll load the match day vlog as well. So stay tuned for those two videos. If I go, you know, hopefully we will go. But if not, then we are back at home next Saturday, where I do play at home against Chorley. So another massive game for us. So you know, we'll be definitely going to that game. But anyway, we've got two vital games, you know, coming up over the next week or so. You know, two must-win games now. So, you know, my personal opinion, we've got to get at least 4 points out of these two now. Because, you know, I was looking at the results early on today. And, to be honest, no, we actually, you know, we did actually drop a place today. So we are, you know, we are down to 10th now. However, results actually did go our way today, because we, you know, we're still 5 points away from the playoffs. So, you know, still got that cushion now. But we have got two games in hand. So we've got Darlington on Tuesday. Then 2 weeks after that, we have Stockport at home. So two, you know, crucial games for us, two cup finals for us. So, you know, if we do get those two wins there, then of course get some other wins in between, then we'll be in a great position as well. So we are back at, you know, back in action on Wednesday. So, you know, we're looking forward to it now. It should be a great day out for us. So we're coming for it now. So of course, I hope you enjoyed the video today. Please leave a like, subscribe to my channel. Feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. So hopefully I'll see you on Wednesday. But if not, see you on Saturday.